So good morning, students. In today's Internet of Things lecture, we will discuss about machine to IoT. So we will take a look on what is machine to machine communication, and then we will do what is the difference between IoT and M2M, which is very, very important because these two terms are used interchangeably. What is M2M and what is IoT? It is very, very important to discuss. So this chapter is all about M2M to IoT, machine to machine communication to Internet of Things. We will cover various topics in this. First of all, we will cover the introduction of machine to machine communication, as we have already discussed the introduction of IoT. Now we will discuss the introduction of machine to machine communication, and then we will do machine to machine value chain. And then we will do IoT value chain and IoT enabling technologies, then MANET and wireless communication network. These are some of the topics which we will cover in unit 2, that is machine to machine to IoT. So first of all, what is machine to machine communication? To understand machine to machine communication, aap ek example lijiye. If your vehicle cloud talk like, I am driving too fast, my engine needs a tune up, and many etc examples. So what would you say? This is an example of M2M communication, two machines communicating here with each other. So this is an example of machine to machine communication. So M2M stands for machine to machine communication. It is a concept that enables network devices to perform action by exchange information without the manual assistance of humans. So what are the basic three traits in M2M communication? First is, they have the ability to connect to the common network. Actually, the devices that communicate with each other, they have the ability to connect to a common network. And then the machines can communicate or exchange data with each other, because they collect data and then they communicate and exchange data because they are connected to the network. So machine to machine refers to direct communication between devices using wired or wireless network. And one more thing is there in this, these communication can occur without manual human interference or input. Human intervention is not there. It is all without the help of the human input or without the help of the human intervention. So M2M and IoT are almost synonyms. The exception is IoT typically refers to wireless communication, whereas M2M wired bhi ho sakta hai aur wireless bhi ho sakta hai. So there are some differences between IoT and M2M. Either we can say these terms can be used interchangeably, but there are some important differences between IoT and M2M. These are the some difference that is shown in this table. First of all, abbreviation. Abbreviation means M2M stands for, M2M is the full form of M2M is machine to machine communication. See here, M2M stands for machine to machine communication. M, machine, to machine. And then IoT stands for Internet of Things, as we have done in unit 1. IoT stands for Internet of Things. Second parameter for difference is philosophy. M2M is a concept, means definition. Here is the this point is all about the defining the M2M and defining the IoT. So M2M is a concept where two or more machines can communicate with each other without the human intervention. And IoT is an ecosystem of connected devices where the devices have ability to collect and transfer data over a network automatically without human intervention. Third is connection type. In M2M, point-to-point connection is there. And in IoT, through IP network using various communication types. In M2M, two machines that are communicating to each other, they are connected to point-to-point. So point-to-point connection is there. And in IoT, IP addresses is provided in through IP network using various communication types. Next is communication protocols. As we already discussed in IoT, various types of protocols are used in IoT infrastructure. For example, ZigBee, Bluetooth, these are used for the short range connectivity and ethernet ho gaya, local area network, and then long range network, LoRa WAN, long range wide area network. So these are used for various internet connectivities, and some data protocols we will use. MQTT is there, DDS is there, data distribution protocol, message queue transport protocol. So these are the some protocols we have to, we see used in the IoT, Internet of Things. And old proprietary protocols and communication techniques have been used in the machine to machine communication. Value chain we will discuss in next lecture. Value chain is linear for machine to machine communication, and value chain is multi-sided for IoT communication. And next is focus area. In machine to machine, for monitoring and control of one or few infrastructure or assets to address everyday needs of human. Now, sharing of collected data, next parameter is the difference between machine to machine and IoT. How sharing of collected data is different in both the terms, both the techniques. Data collected is not shared with the other applications. मशीन टू मशीन में क्या है कि जो डेटा कलेक्ट हो रहा है वो बाकी एप्लीकेशंस के साथ शेयर नहीं होगा, बट व्हाट हैपेंस इन आईओटी, डेटा इज शेयर्ड विद अदर एप्लीकेशंस, जैसे वेदर फोरकास्ट हो गया, सोशल मीडिया हो गया, इम्प्रूव एंड यूजर्स एक्सपीरियंस. सो नेक्स्ट इज डिवाइस डिपेंडेंसी. डिवाइसेस यूजुअली डोंट रिलाई ओवर इंटरनेट कनेक्शन. ये विदाउट इंटरनेट कनेक्शन, उस टाइम लाइव इंटरनेट कनेक्शन इज नॉट मैंडेटरी इन मशीन टू मशीन कम्युनिकेशन. And devices usually rely over internet connection in IoT, Internet of Things. Then is device in scope. Limited devices in scope in machine-to-machine communication, and in IoT, large number of devices in scope. Scalability. IoT से जो M2M है वो less scalable है, और IoT जो है वो more scalable है due to cloud-based architecture. As we have seen in the introduction of IoT, that all the data from by filtering on the gateway that is transferred to the cloud. So this is a very very scalable technique. IoT is very very scalable technique due to this cloud based architecture. Next is example of M2M is remote monitoring, fleet control, and example of IoT is smart cities, smart agriculture, etc. And many other examples of IoT are there, like in healthcare, in homes, in cars, many other examples exist. Now, business type for machine to machine is business to business communication is there, and business type for IoT is business to business communication and business to customer communication. It consists of both the business types, that is B2B and B2C. Technology integration in machine to machine is vertical, and in IoT is vertical and horizontal. So these are the some difference between machine to machine and IoT, and some other related terms are in M2M sensors, some other related terms are sensors, data and information, and in IoT end users, devices, wearables, cloud and big data. These are some related terms which we must know about this in case of IoT infrastructure. When we want to develop any IoT infrastructure, when we do practical for IoT, then we must know about the end users, we must know about the devices, we must know about the wearables, clouds and big data. So these are the some related terms in case of IoT. So this table shows a lot of difference between M2M and IoT. Next come on various system components of machine to machine solution. We have already seen the components of IoT. There are various components of IoTs like cloud, internet connectivity, devices. Devices consist of sensors, actuators, and some other devices are there which collect data, and then end users, and then cloud, that is gateways. These are the some components which we have seen in that we required in IoT infrastructure. Now there are some components which we require in M2M solution. So what are these key components for M2M solutions are sensors. See, here is this diagram show asset connected to the M2M devices. These M2M devices may be sensors, may be actuators, or may be anything. So first of all, enabling a sensor to communicate data it records to application software. फॉर एग्जाम्पल टेम्परेचर सेंसर, मॉइस्चर सेंसर, कोई भी सेंसर हो सकता है ये, ठीक है. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट कॉम्पोनेंट एंड देन इट इज कनेक्टेड विद द नेटवर्क. दिस इज द नेटवर्क, इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी वी विल रिक्वायर हियर. देन इज द सर्विस एनेबलमेंट. थर्ड कॉम्पोनेंट इज द सर्विस एनेबलमेंट एंड एट लास्ट एप्लीकेशन विल बी देयर. सर्विस एनेबलमेंट एट द प्रोसीजर फॉर ऑल दिस इट रिड्यूसेस द कॉस्ट ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. सर्विस एनेबलमेंट रिड्यूसेस द कॉस्ट ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. सो दिस component is also very very important. So these are some key components of M2M solution. First one is sensors, second is RFID, radio frequency identification network, okay. So enabling a sensor to communicate the data, the application software, last is application. Application software can use it, that data that is collected by the help of the with the help of the devices. So these are the components of machine to machine communication. Now there are some applications of machine to machine communication. Machine to machine communication is used in remote monitoring, because when two machines are connected to each other, maybe they lie on the remote, they lie on different areas. So first one is remote monitoring, second is in warehouse management to remote control, robotics, traffic control, supply chain management, fleet management, logistic services and telemedicine services. These are the some applications of machine to machine communications, means two machines connected to each other and they communicate to each other. That are the examples of machine to machine communication. So next is, what are the benefits of M2M? There are lot of benefits of M2M. Now we see the concept of machine to machine communication. Kya benefits ho sakte hain, kya advantages ho sakte hain? First of all, it improves the efficiency and production of machines, because it collects a lot of data. So by this efficiency or production of machines jo hai wo kya hogi, improve hogi. And then is to increase the reliability and safety of complex system. It also increases the reliability and safety of the complex system, and to encourage the life cycle management for key assets and products. So machine to machine, these are the some advantages of machine to machine communication. So now we will we have done the introduction and the application of both in both the technologies, that is M2M and that is IoT. Now if we want to do the value chain of both these technologies, the value chain of IoT and the value chain of M2M, so we are able to do it. What is the value chain of M2M? What is M2M value chain? What is IoT value chain? So first of all, what is value chain? Here name comes again and again, again and again. What is value chain? Value chain, before going to the value chain of M2M, before going to the value chain of IoT, we must know the what is the value chain, what is the term value chain means. So a value chain is a business model that describes the full range of activities needed to create a product. Value chain ka matlab kya hota hai, kisi bhi product ko create karne ke liye, kisi bhi product ko banane ke liye jo sabhi ki sabhi activities involved hoti hain, that is called the value chain. So that's why value chain is called, it is a business model that describes the full range of activities. For example, the diagram shown on your screen, what it shows, it shows the various activities from input to the packaging, from input to the distribution and marketing of the product. So these are some activities involved, full range of activities involved needed to create a product or service. Input, production, processing, packaging, distribution, market. So these are the some activities involved in the production of anything. So for companies that produce goods, value chain comprises the steps that involve bringing a product from conception to distribution and everything in between. Raw material se leke wo kis tarah se banta hai, kis tarah se pack hota hai, kis tarah se aage market mein distribute hota hai, और किस तरह से वो आगे हमें उसमें कुछ और एनहेंसमेंट करनी होती है, कुछ और इम्प्रूवमेंट करनी होती है, इट इंक्लूड्स ऑल दीज स्टेप्स. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द वैल्यू चेन. ये हमारे पास किसकी डेफिनेशन है? वैल्यू चेन की डेफिनेशन. सो नाउ कम ऑन द एम टू एम वैल्यू चेन. दिस डायग्राम शोज एम टू एम वैल्यू चेन. By this diagram, we are able to show the various activities that is involved in the production of any product due to M2M. First step is input. जब भी हम कुछ बनाएंगे, whenever we want to produce anything, input का मतलब क्या है कि raw ingredients, जिसे हमें product में convert करना है, that is called input. Input stands for, input are the base raw ingredient that are turned into a product. फॉर एग्जाम्पल हमने चॉकलेट बनानी है और चॉकलेट बनाने के लिए इनपुट क्या रहेगा? कोकोआ बीन्स रहेंगी. सो हेयर द इनपुट एग्जाम्पल इज कोकोआ बीन्स. सो हेयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ इनपुट यू आर एबल टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज इनपुट. इनपुट स्टैंड्स फॉर रॉ मटेरियल दैट आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू प्रोडक्ट. सो दिस इज इनपुट. For example, cocoa beans in case of chocolate. This is the example of input. That cocoa beans gets converted into chocolate. That cocoa beans is the raw material for raw ingredient for turning it into a product. और M2M machine का क्या role रहेगा इसमें? Data from the M2M device that will be turned into a piece of information. मशीन क्या चेक करेगी कि जो डेटा एंटर कर रहा है वो अब पीस ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन जो में कन्वर्ट होगा, चॉकलेट में कन्वर्ट होगी कोकोआ बीन्स. सेकंड इज प्रोडक्शन. प्रोडक्शन और मैन्युफैक्चर, सेकंड स्टेप, सेकंड एक्टिविटी इन्वॉल्वड इन द एम टू एम वैल्यू चेन इज प्रोडक्शन और मैन्युफैक्चर. सो प्रोडक्शन और मैन्युफैक्चर रेफर्स टू द प्रोसेस दैट द रॉ इनपुट्स आर पुट थ्रू टू बिकम पार्ट ऑफ द वैल्यू चेन. अब उसके ऊपर कुछ प्रोसेसेस अप्लाई किए जाएंगे, लाइक कोकोआ बीन्स के ऊपर क्या अप्लाई किया जाएगा, मे बी ड्राइड एंड सेपरेटेड बिफोर बीइंग ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द ओवरसीज मार्केट. अब दैट कोकोआ बीन्स दैट आर द रॉ मटेरियल फॉर कन्वर्टिंग इनटू द प्रोडक्ट, फॉर कन्वर्टिंग इनटू द चॉकलेट, उसे हमने क्या करना है, उसके ऊपर ड्राइड एंड सेपरेटेड. दीज टू एक्टिविटीज हैव बीन परफॉर्म्ड इन केस ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड मैन्युफैक्चर. एंड व्हाट डज M2M डू हियर? It needs to be verified and tagged for provenance. If from where it is originated, it is verified or not. This is the working of machine here in case of production and manufacture. Third step is processing. As its name suggests, processing refers to the process where product ko puri tarah se kiske liye ready karna, sale ke liye ready karna. That is known as processing. Means product is prepared for sale. All the activities, all the processes that convert a data or raw material into a product that is ready for sale in the market. So what is example here? For example, cocoa beans now turned into cocoa powder and ready for use in the chocolate. Before making the chocolate bars, either it is cube or it is rectangle, any shape, first of all cocoa beans gets converted into powder. So what does M2M do here? M2M refers to the aggregation of multiple data sources to create an information component, something that is ready to be combined with other data sets. Kuch aur information uske liye required hai, use kisi aur cheez ke sath. How that powder will be merged with the sugar, how much amount of sugar will be added for this. So this is all about what this is all about, the processing. Next is packaging. Packaging means ab uski wrap out karna, wrapping karna. It is the process whereby a product can be branded. For example, Kit Kat. For example, Dairy Milk. For example, any other brand for the chocolate, Milky Bar. So unke aage unke kya karna? Wrappers ready karna, taki wo ek as a brand recognize ho sake. So that is known as packaging. अब क्या होगा, जैसे अगर हम किटकैट का एग्जाम्पल लेते हैं तो रेड कलर का रैपर उस पर लगाया जाता है और बहुत सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन उस पर स्टोर की जाती है कि यू हैव टू स्टोर इट इन ऑन दैट टेम्परेचर, उसकी एक्सपायरी डेट, उसका डेट ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चर. तो पैकेजिंग के केस में मशीन का काम यही होता है, इट कंबाइन विद द wrapper, it combines a lot of information, like what is the manufacture date of that chocolate, what is the expiry date of that chocolate, हमें किस टेम्परेचर पे उसे स्टोर करना है, एंड एनी अदर इंफॉर्मेशन दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड, और उसमें शुगर कंटेंट क्या है, कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, फैट्स, सो ऑल दीज आर इंक्लूडेड ऑन द रैपर. सो दैट इज द वर्किंग ऑफ मशीन हियर इन केस ऑफ पैकेजिंग. एंड लास्ट वन इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड मार्केटिंग. In case of distribution and marketing, now the product go to the market by any channel with the help of any transportation method. Now a chocolate may be sold at a supermarket or even online. There are many ways to travel to this product to the market. So now what does M2M do here? M2M take the feedback from the users, will have produced an information product that can be used to create new knowledge. And then with the help of the feedback, if any changes want to do in this product, for example, pehle dairy milk without almonds ke or bubble taste now will be available, jams add ho gayi. So wo kis reason se hui ki market se jo feedback humne li from the customer, that feedback means a lot, and according to that feedback, new product will launch in the market. So this is all about M2M value. These are the various activities that is involved in the M2M value chain. So the five activities that is involved in M2M value chain is input, production, processing, then packaging, and then distribution and marketing. So these are the some activities and their example, what role M2M plays in this. So I hope this M2M chain has been clear to all of you. Now this is the detail of all the activities that is involved in the diagram. From activities from input, production, their example is there with this. Like in input, example is cocoa beans. Cocoa beans are the raw material. And then M2M example. What does M2M do here? So I hope all these concepts have been clear to you. M2M value chain has been clear to you. And we will discuss IoT value chain in our next lecture. Thank you.